much for inviting us back again. I was here in February. I recognize some of you. I think I saw some of you in February. I looked way different, and I sang very different music. Many languages, actually. Well, I am singing some Gaelic today. And this is my mother. Yeah. We've collaborated since, of course, I was a baby in her womb.
That's true. That's when I was studying my piano 5 hours a day or whatever we spent when we were working on a degree. Oh, wow. And she was in there.
So in 2013, I went over to Austria and was performing and studying opera and classical music while I was over there. And when I came back, I said, hey, we should start singing Celtic. I don't know where that came from. Well, there was no Celtic over there. I don't know where it came from. But so, yeah, so since 2013, we've been collaborating. We used to call ourselves Alassie and Hermither. And yes. And of course, you know, as you get older, things change. And but I'm so glad that we're back collaborating again. This has just been lots of fun. We're hoping to come back to Red Deer. I love the little old Anglican church downtown here, and I think it would be perfect. I have a lovely harpist that has a larger Celtic harp that we're hoping to collaborate, and I'm hoping we can get back before Christmas. Is kind of the plan. We're also going to do some I actually have November 26th booked in Olds. It's a small venue though. And yeah, so enjoy!
I think she did forget to tell you though.
Oh,
my mother was Irish.
Oh, yes.
So I am half Irish. So she's a quarter Irish, and her dad was English. So
who thought he was a Scotsman?
So we feel we're kind of Celtic.
Very Celtic. Okay. Well, actually, on my father's side, we stem from a long history of Vikings, so you didn't know that one.
Okay, let's start.
All right, we will begin. In this setting, so I think it's better to keep it closed. My dad loved the Irish Rovers, and so I have a few selections that are kind of in the style of the Irish Rovers. I probably know every song they've ever done because my dad listened to it constantly, even though he thought he was a Scotsman. So this next one's kind of, yeah, it's, when we were picking music back in the day, I said we have to do this song because I love this song. So I sing it from a narrative perspective instead of as the man. You ready?
Yep.
Over her shoulder. Can I tell them how old you are?
No. I don't care.
She's 84. I know.
Well, I have to tell you, I used to be able to play the harp quite well. I learned this when I was older anyway, but it's been really hard this time. I have worked so hard to get my brain back working. And my eyes, mainly my eyes.
Yeah, so what happens sometimes when you're looking through, like if there's an audience, it's hard to look through the strings and
yeah,
see the
see
strings, because
right
it's tricky.
Okay.
It is tricky. I yeah. So, most of the things I'll be doing on the drum are just more of a beat than actually, like, doing, you know, when you get into it. I do have one song I do a little bit, but other songs I do, I can get right into it, so. But today, we keep it a little more mellow.
The hardest thing are your eyes, right? These strings, I can't see, I can hardly see them at my age, and so it's been really tough, but I'm still doing it anyway.
You are still doing it, it's fantastic. So, the next selection is something that I've arranged that is a familiar Lorena McKinnitt song, if you follow Lorena McKinnitt. It's actually something that she does in her Christmas selections, and I have performed this lots in Christmas, Celtic Christmas productions, where we've had many other instruments as well. And but I always like to play my little tin whistle with this one as well. So yeah, there you go.
Thank you.
a way different breath control than being a classical singer. So you have to control every little breath or else it just squawks on you. And the smaller the one, the more. So, yeah. Getting educated today as well.
I'm
Come, O love, quickly come to me, softly move, come to the door and away will flee, and safe for I may my darling be. So thank you for inviting us. It's been great. I hope you enjoyed it as much as we did. And I'm sure I'll be back again. With something totally different.
Thank you. Thank you.
seem to be able to. I've done some of the before here. I've worked so hard to put it together. I've worked hard to see my parents so hard to service me.
Well, anyway, I'm
exam musical piano. And I said,
yes,
what are you doing? I have to take that to the exam. He said, you might forget. I said, what kind of experience to compass did you not get? Can you imagine?
Oh, I know. You have to live like this.
Kind of like saxophone players, they play these awful keys for me.
Yeah,
I know.
I mean, because it's a transposing instrument.
Well, no.
Yeah, but
keys are horrible for the piano.
I know. I mean, it was great to one or two. It was simple. I was just going, you know, like this for a song. Telling me how to come. You might forget it. I don't think so.
Oh my gosh! Well, you
know,
you're a singer. I'm going to go say I want to graduate.
I want a program. I want to get a program.
And it's control. You have to have she got a
picture. I think you have to. Down to my, like I have a walker over there.
Oh, I do. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I do that with a lot of backup music, though.
I had the piano open to begin with, and the first one I was like, that's loud, I'm shutting up. So that's
a hard
thing.